time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. Hollis fields it at the 13. He makes it to the 28-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Go to the run, and he's tackled in the backfield for a loss.
The defense was playing run all the way right there, and it paid off for him.
Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on the 25. And he can't get away from the pressure.
Going to the tight end here on third down. It's not even about the defense not expecting it, because I think they did. It's about mismatches. He's probably bigger and stronger than the guy who's trying to cover it.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 38. He tried to run up the middle that met in the backfield. They come out on an empty backfield. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
I love to see a confident quarterback, but you don't want to just go back there and put blind faith into your throws. You need a little bit more time to evaluate the coverage before you release the football.
They'll make the sack.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. Woods is waiting for the snap. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. He's pushed out of bounds, right around the 34.
The Bearcats and their coaching staff, Kirk, just happy to have a guy like this in the program. Their offense really clicks when he's playing well.
Well, I think it gives them the diversity that they're looking for. I mean, at times they're going to run the football, other times they're going to try to air it out. And when you have one guy that gets so much attention on the outside, it just seems to open up other aspects of their offensive attack. And they've done a good job as an offensive staff of putting together a good plan, and I'm sure we're going to see it again today.
He's tackled at the 22.
When you combine his speed as a runner with the strength of the offensive line, you have the potential for some long runs.
First and 10 following that big run. Scrambling around. Tackle made at the 11-yard line.
One thing about this quarterback is when the play breaks down, he has a way of improvising and getting positive yards.
First and 10. Ball on the 11. And he's taken down around the 13-yard line. 2-yard loss for the halfback.
from the 6-yard line. Third down. Defensive coordinator anticipating this 5-wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. They'll bring him down at the 1-yard line.
The quarterback didn't see anybody open downfield, so he took it himself and picked up some decent yardage.
And it pays off. Touchdown. Nice time to use the fullback there.
I've always liked when teams mix it up and give the fullback the ball in goal line situations. If the big bruiser can't get you a couple of yards, you don't deserve to get in.
And he adds the extra point. It was a 7-play, 66-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. That can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
He's tackled at the 21-yard line. The Bearcats are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Got an opening. Runs it left for a decent gain. Larkin gains about 5 yards on the option play.
That brings him second and five.
Second and five coming up here. Ball on the 26-yard line. A decent pickup on the pass play.
And I'll tell you what, the defense did everything they could here. Give credit to the quarterback for putting this ball where it had to be for his receiver to catch it. Great job.
Picks up about 4 yards on the play.
That makes it 7-6.
From their own 41-yard line, second down. They make the stop at the 42-yard line. So the option keeper goes for about a yard. It's third and five. Ball on the 42-yard line. And he is drilled at the 30-yard line. After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Woods to punt. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. He's out to the 30. He's taken down at the 39. We've played one. The Bearcats lead 7-0. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Complete over the middle. Brought down at the 41. From the 41-yard line, first down. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. And he's tackled around the 12-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 12. Completes it, and he's hit hard immediately.
Gaining 3 yards. That makes it 7-6.
Two times. Four down.
And down he goes at the 2. 7-yard gain, and that'll be a first down.
And how about the poise of this quarterback to locate his receiver past the sticks and get him the ball? That was a great throw.
And the quarterback didn't waste any time getting rid of that one. He took the snap, and he threw it right out there. First down. Defense trying to prevent any more damage. First and goal inside the 5. There's a play fake. Over the middle. Got it to the halfback. Touchdown.
I thought the quarterback made a nice read right here. He checked off his receivers and went to the open running back.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Koch fields it at the 13, and he just got stood up right there. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. He's taken down at the 30. Short yardage situation here. Second down and 1. Gives it left side. And he tackles him hard at the 33-yard line. So the running back comes away with a short gain on the play, and he also gets a first down.
Smart run. Maybe it won't look great on the stat sheet, but getting the first is what matters.
5 wide. A great tackle at the 25-yard line.
Man, as an offensive lineman, this is the worst thing that you want to see, is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of it.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long.
So sure he made the best decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
The sub package in there defensively in this 5 wide receiver set. And he's tackled right away. He puts it away, and it's a great kick. And he's hammered down. The Bearcats offensive staff, I think, has done a good job of keeping their wide receiver in the game. Even though he's not having great stats, he's part of it, and the rest of the team now is picking up his slack, I think.
Well, this offense is still putting points on the board, and I think at times they're actually using the wide receiver, the go-to man who's drawing so much attention. Really as a decoy, open up other avenues of this offense. We've seen other receivers make some plays. They're running the football. So it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments this defense makes to try to slow down these other members of this offense. And who knows, maybe that could open it back up for that marquee receiver.
The halfback with a carry. Tackle at about the 49. From the 49-yard line, it's first down. Positive yardage. The The Bearcats will use their first time out of the half. He gets to about the 31-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 14 yards.
First and 10. Ball on the 31. Just throws this one away. Tackled at the 19.
Just another weapon for this offense. He's got good hands, and he's tough to bring down. He showed right there that he can make something big happen.
The defender had it and then dropped it.
Man, I don't know if this quarterback misread the defense or just made a poor decision, but that wasn't a pass he should have thrown.
Here's the eighth play of the series.
Brad, you just don't see this very often anymore in college football. That is their fifth first down on this drive alone. They have great rhythm right now as an offense, and look at that poor defense. They're looking over the sidelines to the defensive coordinator for some help. They need to change things up.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. And they're in. Touchdown.
Great job of some tough running right there. When you get close to the end zone, things get very tight, and it's tough to maneuver.
And he converts the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. They'll spread the field with five wide. Tackle made at about the 33-yard line. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
You can tell he's got a lot of faith in his wide receivers. Even when he's a little bit off target, they can pull it in and make something happen.
He's out of bounds right around the 36-yard line. Good pass to his receiver to get the first down.
Since he only needed a few yards, the little dump off pass worked to perfection.
They bring him down.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
So the sack makes this a second and long. Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback. He's going to try and scramble. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. Slides down to the ground. Flag down, and I'm not sure when it was thrown. Let's find out.
Flipping. Offense.
That one will put the offense in a hole, and they'll try to get some of that back on this upcoming play. From their own 35-yard line. Second down. Steps out of bounds around the 42-yard line.
That'll bring up third and four.
Cut and left, cut and left. Four down. Mike four.
He steps out at the 45-yard line.
That'll make it fourth and two.
Woods is waiting for the snap. Booming kick. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. The Bearcats are just cruising through this first half, Herbie. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, but still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that's a four-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
Fires out to his receiver, and he's immediately tackled.
I think he could have taken a risk down the field, but he played it safe instead, and that's one of the keys to winning ball games.
From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. We've played a half. The Bearcats lead 21-0. Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This offense has really seemingly been unstoppable. Should be interesting to see now if the defense has changed things up as they try to stop these guys. Nice run, and he's brought down. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. He's to the 40. And he's taken down around the 46-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Here's the halfback. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line.
That brings up second and 9.
From their own 47-yard line, it's second down. Throws complete, and he's hit right away. He's at the 30, makes it to the 24. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big gain.
From the 24-yard line, first down. Inside the 10, he's in, another touchdown.
Boy, did he look determined running the football. Nobody was going to keep him out of the end zone.
And he adds the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. The Bearcats continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
Not a whole lot's been working for them so far. They should just come out and play loose and easy because they've got nothing to lose. Quick strike to the receiver. They'll bring him down around the 33-yard line.
That makes it second and 2.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
Mike four.
They come out in a 5-wide set. throws complete, and they make the stop around the 48-yard line.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they looked sharp before this one even started.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Here's the throw. I don't think he got anything on that.
That'll make it second and 7.
Hit and taken down. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
From the 36-yard line, first down. And they got him.
They simply have too much speed for this offensive line. They're just too quick off the ball.
That'll make it second and long.
It out to his receiver in a hurry. Brought down around the 22-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 22. With room to run, and he's level at the 12.
Number 7 on the tackle at the 12-yard line. That'll make it second and inches.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback, and he's tackled at the 12-yard line.
You know, the great thing about a screen pass is, once it's executed, is to watch the linemen get downfield and have a chance to show their athletic ability in the open field. These guys are close to 300 pounds, some cases over 300 pounds, and here they are in the open field.
Fires quickly, and they got it. Touchdown. Nice catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
And the secondary didn't quite seem alert enough to defend that pass. And he tacks on the extra point. So a 9-play, 76-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill to not see the ball touch the ground. This time they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and the receiver.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So their last drive resulted in 6 points. Do you think we'll see the same result on this one?
They ran the ball extremely well on their last drive. And until this defense figures out how to stop it, I think they'll have no problem moving the ball down the field.
Throws it in a hurry.
That makes it second and 2.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. They hand it off. And down he goes around the 47-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
You drives it to the back. Runs outside for a nice gain.
That's a D4 run play. That makes it second and six.
It's second down, 6 yards to go. Ball on the 49-yard line. He's taken down at the 49-yard line.
He knew it was a run all the way. Got a good jump. Once he got there, he wasn't about to let him slip away either.
We head to the fourth. The Bearcats with a 3-touchdown advantage. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Setting up blockers, the running back's got it on the screen. Tackle at the 47-yard line. And they could really put their opponent in bad field position with a good punt here. They got into the end zone last time. Let's see if they can match that on this possession. Here's the halfback on the screen. He's tackled right around the 30.
That makes it second and eight.
Second and eight. Ball on their own 30. Caught with room to work. Tackle made at midfield. Midfield. It's first down. In the shotgun and 5 wideouts. Pass complete and taken down immediately.
That makes it second and six.
Scrambling around, and he's sacked.
Called a loss of 6 yards. That brings us third and 12.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 40.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
Looks quick to his tight end, and he can't hang on. And they're going to have to give the ball back after going for it on fourth and long.
Not much you can do there. You got to go for it and give yourselves a chance.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He's gobbled up in the backfield. Loss of one there for the halfback. From the 49-yard line, second down. Just under 3 to go in regulation. forward to about the 49. And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
And he took a shot on that play, Brad. It looks like his head might be still ringing a little bit.
The 43-yard line.
Fires quickly, and he's got his man.
The offense didn't appear to be in sync on that series.
Koch awaiting the return. And this one is a beauty.
This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around.
It out. Caught by the sophomore to the 10. Touchdown. Huge play.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Taken down at the 43-yard line. The offense is looking to be a little bit more successful with this drive as they had to punt the ball away the last time they had it. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. And they get nice yardage on that run. Impressive might be an understatement, folks. He's at 200 yards rushing.
Really quality game for this guy today. He ought to be very happy with his production.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. The Spartans are going to call their second timeout. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Gets out to around the 25. And he has a huge run.
I'll tell you right now, this guy is arguably one of the fastest players in college football today. There you see him turn it upfield with such fluidity and quickness.
Another run. Inside the 10. He's knocked out of bounds around the 2-yard line. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. They come out in a goal line set. Caught end zone for the touchdown. That's the whipped cream on the top of this game, Kirk. Converts the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They punched it in for 6 on the last series. Can they do it again?
Well, I think this defense has got to do something because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
Sack was the intended receiver on the play.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25. We have less than a minute to go. And a quick throw. And he's taken down at the 42-yard line.
Here you go.
incomplete. Brought down. Nothing doing. The spike will stop the clock.
That makes it 37.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 48. Throws it deep. And he got it to the sophomore. And he scores. Touchdown.
This guy just continues to impress me. Every time I watch this team play, he seems to come up with big plays.
Once he got the ball, he did all the heavy lifting to take it to the house. He makes the PAT.
This is turning into a shootout here. Now, remember, the last time we saw this offense out in the field, they answered the bell and scored a touchdown. Can they do that now a second time?
This offense really ran the ball well as they finished off their last drive with a touchdown. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. He'll go down to one knee. Bearcats coaching staff, Kirk, do they start wondering, hey, are we going to have trouble with our star player after the struggles he had today?
Well, I think the coaching staff's got to be happy that this team is able to win the football game and overcome the fact that their star player didn't have a great game. But I think making adjustments and changing the game plan because their star didn't deliver, I think that would be a big mistake.
That brings this broadcast to a close. 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.